A lot of people are taking Tadalafil or Cialis as a brand name along TRT. Why do they do that? What are the benefits of it? And do you recommend it, Gil?
Yes, Tadalafil is the generic name or the medical name of the drug, also known as Cialis. Cialis is a brand name. And most guys don't realize, because when you mention Cialis, they automatically think erectile dysfunction. Long before Cialis was an erectile dysfunction medication, Tadalafil was actually used to treat blood pressure, and it was dosed on a lower scale on a daily basis. Then they figured out that, hey, these guys who were given Tadalafil to are actually reporting to experience better erections and better erectile quality over time in terms of duration and firmness, while we're really just trying to treat blood pressure. So the makers of Cialis said, hey, if we can patent this as a drug and give it a name, we can actually sell it as, you know, a form of a Viagra with a longer half-life. I do believe that Cialis was actually introduced before Viagra. I have to go back and double check that for sure. Tadalafil as a generic was out there before Viagra was. But either way you chop it, guys always constantly think, well, this is an ED drug. I don't have ED. Why would I need this? Remember that a low-dose daily Tadalafil acts in a very different mechanism than a lot of blood pressure medications. What this does is actually inhibits the constriction of your veins and arteries. So in a sense, it's called a PDE5 inhibitor. By inhibiting this action, you are allowing for vasodilation. It increases nitric oxide. It opens up your blood vessels. It allows more blood flow and improves circulation. This is how it lowers blood pressure. It's like taking a fire hose and running the same amount of volume of water as you did via a garden hose. The volume doesn't change, but the pressure is reduced. By allowing the blood to pump more fluently and efficiently, you are giving your heart a little bit of a rest. You're giving your kidneys a little bit of a rest, and you are improving the quality of blood flow to your tissues. You're going to get more oxygen, more energy, better erections, better pumps in the gym. And I believe that as a result of lowering the blood pressure, it also has an effect on the prostate by preventing benign prostatic hypertrophy. So this has a good effect as we age, and we know that men's prostates tend to hypertrophy and increase in size and press on the bladder and cause incontinence overnight, usually for guys who are older. This can help prevent this. So we've seen PSA numbers come back better for guys who are using Tadalafil indefinitely. And the normal common dose for daily is 5 mg. It's the most common one you'll find. And that's usually because the Tadalafil tablets come in 20 milligrams. We happen to have an ODT, which is an orally dissolvable tablet that goes under your tongue, does not require water. Helps a little bit with the first liver pass, which a lot of guys complain that can cause some GI issues. And this will come in a 25 milligram tablet that is scored into quarters. So when you break it, you got 6.25 milligrams. And I found that this is a tremendous tool for pre-workouts. The vasodilation effect and the blood pumps you get out of this is great. And to know that it has improved health benefits on top of this is really nice as well. So I do think this is a nice tool to add for TRT. And for a lot of our guys over 40 that begin TRT, we often recommend that they start a daily Tadalafil regimen with it. This also goes to help with those guys who are very concerned with the erythrocytosis and blood viscosity. Again, we have a whole video on that and why it's not as big of a deal as guys think. But if you do have concerns there, remember, dilating your blood vessels and allowing for more blood to flow more easily can alleviate some of the viscosity concerns as well. So this is a nice way to combat a mild elevation in hemoglobin for those that have that concern. Overall, I do believe that daily Tadalafil is a nice benefit for some. And I think for more people that it is than it isn't. And, you know, unless you really have gastrointestinal issues or it is contraindicated for some nitroglycerin and possibly other blood pressure medications, because you don't want to have a compounding effect of lowering blood pressure too much. So, if that's not the case, if you're not too hypotensive as a result of your other meds, by all means, this is something that I would consider, and I do use it myself.
And that's 5 mg in the AM?
Ideally, I like it during the day because I like it during my waking hours. Like I said, I find benefits in the gym with it as well. So to me, it's something I use in the morning. If you want to take it before bed, remember, this is a 36-hour half-life. So when you take it throughout the 24-hour cycle, really doesn't matter, because by about, you know, day 7 or 8, you're already at a steady state after having the doses compounded. You're pretty much stable all the time. I just take it in the morning as part of my morning routine. When I wake up, I leave it on my nightstand, and on my way to brush my teeth, I grab a quarter of a tablet. It goes under my tongue, and by the time I reach my toothbrush, it's already dissolved.
Oh, you have these kind of trojans?
Yeah, so it's an ODT. It's an orally dissolvable tablet. Mm-hmm. So think of like a sugar pill almost. Like, you literally break it with your fingers and it goes under your tongue. It's got no flavor. And within about 10 seconds, it turns into like a powder, mixes with your saliva. I keep it sublingually for about another 15 seconds, let it absorb into the capillaries of the tongue and swallow whatever's left over. And there's no need for water or anything. They come in individually wrapped little tin foils, and you can even throw them in your pocket if you're traveling.
We don't have that here.
It's compounded. Yeah, it's a compounded medication. Mm.
Hey, thank you for watching. And do this next. Watch one of these videos to learn a ton more about hormone optimization.